Hello everyone, this is Chagawad here, and today I'm going to be presenting to you my top 5 evil pre-war companies of Fallout. Apparently I had put this list together about 2 years ago, and then just set it to the side and forgot about it, but I found it again and still wanted to do it, so please enjoy. Up at number 5, I have chosen Nuka-Cola. The Nuka-Cola Corporation was founded by John Caleb Bradburton after the creation of the soft drink Nuka-Cola that took the United States by storm. During their time, Nuka-Cola stole military equipment and waged war against the Vimpop Corporation by attacking its employees, trucks, and even sabotaging production lines. This all despite the fact that Nuka-Cola was already found on every street in the USA, and the drink was popular enough for Bradburton to open up the amusement park Nuka World. 40,000 visitors came to the park's grand opening, and many new attractions were added before its demise. The last location added to the park was the Galactic Zone that employed real military equipment from Robco that Bradburton controlled from within the park in order to defend himself. Bradburton embezzled funds and even donated some of his beverageers to the military in order to give himself full protection, prioritizing himself over the visitors of the park and his many employees. The corporation, wanting to create a new drink for even more popularity, began experimenting with the isotope of strontium-90, used as the coating for power armor, and put it in their newest drink, Nuka-Cola Quantum. 62 test subjects died after ingesting the drink, until a safer isotope was created and the drink was mass-produced. Finally, Bradburton took the last final step to ensure his survival and was beheaded and placed in a life support machine to continue to live in Nuka World for the rest of his days. 4. Dunwich Boers LLC. Owner of the Dunwich Building in Washington and Dunwich Boers in the Commonwealth, the higher management of this company had strange connections to the occult that still linger in the sights of the company even after nuclear war. Within the bowels of the Dunwich Building lies the altar of Og Qualtoth, an obelisk of evil energy that has cursed the building. Before the war, Dunwich Boers was also the site of a cruel ritual sacrifice that the management inflicted upon the employees to appease a strange, supernatural entity. Within the dig site, one can find a partially buried statue of a face submerged in water. Some of the employees of Dunwich Boers can still be found as deformed, feral ghouls, still trapped within the site of the company that betrayed them. Dunwich Boers LLC is probably one of the most mysterious companies of Fallout, as no one knows how tight the connections were with the occult. 3. Hallucigen Incorporated. A rather unsuccessful company, Hallucigen specialized in the development of supposedly non-lethal chemicals. They brought on the lead designer of the Mesmetron from Implied Hypnotics to help with the development of their products, many of which were gases to be used for pacification and riot control. Poseidon Energy, another evil corporation, once used hallucinogen gas in an attempt to embarrass and suppress workers holding a peaceful strike, but the gas turned them into a rampaging horde. The Mesmetron researcher was eventually fired due to a string of catastrophic tests that resulted in the deaths of many test subjects. The safety of company executives was always the highest priority at Hallucigen, and if chemical spills occurred at times, test subjects would just be left in unused facilities, still alive and sealed within their test chambers to be left to die. The company was also hired by Vault-Tec to create a gas that would change the mood of the test subjects. 2. Big Mountain. A privately owned science company, Big Mountain's Research and Development Center was based in the Southwest Commonwealth. The unimaginable breakthroughs were brought to life by the think tank executives. Many of their discoveries never reached full-scale distribution due to finances or simply being sold to the highest bidder. And many of their experiments included the cruel and inhumane treatment of human and animal test subjects. Within the Big Mountain facility, there was even a prison camp called Lil Yangtze, filled with many prisoners of war who barely spoke English and were cruelly experimented on and abused by the guards. Many of the survivors eventually became ghouls. The Big Mountain Research Facility was full of camps, mock towns, laboratories, and even a school. but it was never enough for the scientists. They reached their fingers out to experiment in isolated U.S. towns, sent their defective hazmat suits to the workers at the Sierra Madre, and partnered with Vault-Tec to send dangerous plants into Vault 22. Eventually, for survival, the think tank members turned themselves into robots to continue work and descended into insanity, all developing extreme personalities centered around what they studied. With their bioengineering, the think tank also created many of the dangerous creatures that roam the wastes, such as cazadors and night stalkers. In a crisis of conscience, the director of the science complex, Dr. Mobius, was able to erase the memories of his fellow think tank members, erasing their knowledge of a world outside of Big Mountain, in order to protect the citizens of the waste from their cruel experiments. Those who dare wander into the facility are often stripped of their brain and turned into lobotomites. And for number one, I have chosen Vault-Tec. I'm sure it's no surprise to everyone, it's hard to get more evil than the infamous Vault-Tec Corporation. Vault-Tec won the contract from the federal government to be the sole designers and proprietors of the vaults that were to be built throughout the United States in case of nuclear fallout. Due to lack of money, only 122 vaults were constructed with the help of embezzling funds and cruelly pushing Vault-Tec scientists and employees. Employees of the corporation were kept under an Orwellian rule, down to the time they were even allowed to use the bathroom. Remind you of someone? However, the patriotic and safety-oriented look of the company was simply a smokescreen used to hide the shadow government enacting the Societal Preservation Program. Only 17 of the vaults created were built to function as normal, benign bunkers. The other 105 were all fitted with a different experiment, turning the ignorant residents into test subjects. Overseers of the vaults were instructed that human lives in fact did not matter, and that they should do whatever they can to keep the experiment going for as long as it can. Vault-Tec was given the power to enact its own drills with U.S. citizens in different cities, which they practiced with so much frequency that throughout the years, the turnouts for the drills dwindled. Due to their heinous experiments, most vaults failed after the real fallout. I hope you've enjoyed my list and found it helpful. As my mom said to me a while ago when I was first working on this video, when money is all that matters, it does not bring out the best in people. So if someone tries to tell you that the Fallout games aren't political, or that quote-unquote SJWs are turning them political, you can just tell them that they're dead wrong. Also, please subscribe to my Patreon. Only $5 a month gets you the rank of my companion, and you will get exclusive videos, outtakes, and so much more. It really helps to get that money. I'm not begging or anything, but sometimes I donate it to charity and sometimes I use it so I can get more footage and just make better quality videos. Anyways, remember to like and subscribe. Bye!
Do you believe in kissing, honey? You bet I do. Well, I believe in kissing, honey, when the moon is new.
So as many of you know, I am a citizen of the USA, and currently our country is suffering from a crisis at the border. Immigrants seeking asylum in the U.S. are being detained. Families are being separated and kept in detention centers in horrible conditions. All of it is scary and horrible, and a bit hard to come to terms with. So until things start getting better, I'm placing this message at the end of all of my videos to try to use what little influence I have to bring awareness and help. There are a number of things you can do to help. One of the simplest things is to donate to Immigrant Families Together, who are fundraising money to pay the bonds of detained immigrants and also provide necessities to families, such as hygiene products, food, and shelter. This organization is also looking for volunteers. You can also take direct action by calling your state's government's officials and try to make your voice heard, and also refuse to let your taxes go to fund these facilities. There are many groups online that are looking for help to make sure these people are treated like human beings and receiving the help they desperately need. Let's prove that there is still hope for humanity and help solve this crisis in the most humane way possible. Remember, showing kindness isn't political. It's just the right thing to do. Thank you.